Well, they're about 5 minutes and 55 seconds away from getting number 19 if they continue this pace. Playing solid defense, smart on the offensive end, providing the effort on the glass.
Surprised they played so well after losing Booker with Fox last year's leading score.
Well, really nothing in college basketball should surprise you. I mean, that's the beauty of this game. You know, you got the fallibility of young men, but you also have the ability to rise to the occasion. Guys playing beyond themselves, and certainly you have to factor in development year after year. Guys work hard.
Simmons working hard to get the ball and then get something with it.
They work hard and they get better.
Simmons has gotten better each and every year. As 14 came in averaging 22.
And really, that's the teaching value of intercollegiate sports. And when you talk about what you do in the classroom, but there's also leadership development, self-development out here in competition.
And what can't be ignored is what Creighton athletes have done in the classroom.
They're graduating 95% of their student athletes, which is outstanding. We don't speak enough about that, but that is the mission of the university.
Douglas has shot in and out, and Carter comes back to rebound. Eighth rebound for Justin Carter. Oh, boy. And Carter is grabbing his left knee.
Yeah. And it was braced up and allowed him to play, but he's going to have to see that happen.
Creighton Capital Live and Harriman Farm, Edwardsburg, Maryland. Led the team in rebounding last season. And it makes it a 5-point Creighton lead as we approach the 4-minute mark. Defense! 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 Defense!
Creighton really extended the defense, pressing the ball handlers. And again, it's another change shot. Good position defense. Once the ball handler picks up the dribble and looks to shoot, hands up. You don't have to block it. Just make them change it. The odds and the probability are in the favor of the defender. And Stinnett back there, he's like, but what's the result? And those are the things that make a difference here. And Creighton sees in the moment right now.
They have a tough time luring teams to Omaha from other conferences.
And you just talked about it, 16,000. You know, very passionate about basketball, and with this kind of crowd, it's a trap for a lot of teams.
And it's eight rebounds. Came down on the left knee. Clearly, he's trying to get back in. Quick save, but into the hands of Simmons.
Well, you wonder where Michigan was passing that ball. Very fortunate to have possession right now.
Harris lost it.
Well, look at Antoine Young. This dogger man he has. As long as he's on the perimeter, he's going to do it.
For a school record for losses and then bounce back to the 21.
Well, I'm a believer. I've seen Don Beilein resurrect that West Virginia program in that Heisman race.
17 for Lucas Perry. 4 threes.
Matthew's not mad at me right now. He's Texas fan.
Well, all they need to do is continue to win and end up in the national championship. And Banner of Florida. Stinnett got caught up in the air. It's a bet.
Let's help Craig get out to this lead. You don't want to stop doing that now. They're trying to go one on one.
Carter's out in the game. On the floor for the last 2 minutes.
And once again, Michigan has the tools. Sims inside, Harris, and a ball. Douglas right there. We've got the tools to get to this point and a tie into the new coach Xavier.
This month, doing a fine job at the Musketeers so far. Again, this is Xavier coming up against Marquette. Young with the left hand off the glass. Lost in there.
Oh, tough luck. Kane Lawson right where he needed to be. Ball did everything to go in. And Michigan, once again, execution. Go to their strength.
Sims along for three. This is rebound. Everyone knows Harris is a terrific scorer, but 11 points, 9 rebounds, 9 assists in this one.
Nice job of going up and finishing.
First lead for Michigan. There's still 13 minutes left. Porter at the other end. Lawson tried to keep it alive. Not the way. Creighton gets it back. And Porter wins it out of the
Steve Davis again. The official right on the spot made the comment.
Under a minute to go. First game of the Old Spice Classic. This week presented by Lowe's here on ESPN2. Creighton and 15th ranked Michigan. In a back and forth affair. Harris all the way to the bucket. Paul Ashford for the foul
from the perimeter. He can take it inside. As you saw, he can slash to the basket.
And he problems with his left knee.
Huge miss by Danny Harris.
Michigan 3-for-8 from the line here in the second half.
Best available shot right now. You're not necessarily thinking three unless it's the best available. You got Skinner, and you got Ashford, Slashers, and Young, the quickness. Get off with the perfect five out there on the floor to try to execute here. There's the slash.
Ashford almost had a pick play, and his shot gets away. Tied at 67. Perfect pressure.
Well, B-line wants his team to at least get it to half court. Now they're running 2-on-1 break.
Harris to the hoop.
Back, and I suspect that Ben Altman's going to use it on a miss. Or a miss. The quickness of Young to push it up.
Ready for the final shot here. Young, all the way to the bucket. No! Shot is the final field.
And he's looking at it. He jitterbacked his way all the way to the hole. And you're right. No one picked it up. Spread floor. No help defenders in the paint. And when you see a guy burning out of the paint, you got to close up and at least take the lane away from him. Can't stop the super jump.